second, please.
Hungry.
You're not in uniform. I don't have to be. Well, how do I know you're your police officer?
I don't know if I can.
You've got identification. Don't worry about it. I've spoken to you before.
Message, Sergeant Kendrick.
I don't have an earpiece in, but we have, you can hear it, six individuals. And I'll give you an update.
Are you going to be speaking to the hunt?
Sorry?
Are you going to be speaking to the hunt at all?
We're in communications with the hunt, yeah.
Okay, and what are you going to do about the illegal hunting in here?
Well, we'll address that. It's not a problem.
So you're going to allow it to continue for now?
If you've got a complaint, we'll address that.
We've already made that complaint.
Well, as I say, I'm dealing one thing at a time.
Okay.
Okay. I've came across you guys. First of all, I'm just having a chat.
Okay.
Okay. The issue about any form of illegal hunting, I'll happily take that on board.
Okay.
Okay.
But they're continuing to still do it now, I believe.
I can only do one thing at a time. I'm speaking to you guys.
Okay.
Okay. They've made a complaint. You've made a complaint. I can only deal with one complaint at a time.
Right. Okay. Okay. There it is.
You want to just stand by?
I'm just going to go and monitor.
You're not allowed to monitor. You're not allowed to monitor anything.
Sorry?
You're not allowed to monitor anything.
What do you mean not allowed to monitor anything?
Are you allowed to record people in public?
Huh?
Are you allowed to record people?
What's that got to do with it?
I'm asking you, do you think legally you're allowed to record people?
Well, I'm going to go and make sure they're not breaking the law again.
Okay. Yeah. Well, come and see you in a wee minute. Could you,
Yep.
If you just do it from here. Okay. Well, we basically received a complaint. And obviously this is why we're here. So I was just curious what you're actually doing here.
Checking to see if anyone's breaking the law.
Breaking the law, that's our job. Police's job.
I'm sure it's up to the members of the public as well.
Dressed in this attire in a beautiful sunny morning. Okay. First of all, would you mind putting this all down for me, please? Start recording.
Why?
Because I'm in doing my job and I don't appreciate it. I don't think it's particularly civil, fair, or really just generally quite nice to record me while I'm just having a conversation and trying to do my duty.
Awesome.
Thank you.
I'm not sure you'll see where the news is at.
Yeah.
I do appreciate that, thank you. Have you got anything on you in your possession that could be perceived? That would be equipment that would potentially interfere with a hunt?
Nope.
No?
Camera, batteries, electronic cigarette. Yes.
No. Would you mind just trying to make your pockets for me?
Not if there's anything in these pockets. I've got a pair of gloves. Tissue, a mask.
Okay.
Calypso. Got a phone and stuff is nothing.
Bit of hangers in your pocket?
Clipsilt and my electronic cigarette. See? Nothing sinister there, and there's nothing else in that pocket. Got a bottle of water here.
What's in the pocket?
Just a radio, a camcorder, and nothing else. Don't think about anything else to fall out. That's why I like to wear trousers like this, because you've got good pockets to keep things in.
Appreciate that.
Some milk and some snacks. Yeah, tobacco.
Precisely why you should have one of these.
Possibly. Can I just take your details, please?
For what? For what's the reason?
Well, the reason is we can do it formally because we've been received a complaint that people dressed in this attire and with some video footage from members of the hunt that you've been interfering with a legal event. So we've either been detain you in section 14 of the Criminal Procedure Act, take you to the station, interview you, weigh up the evidence, potentially bring charges, or we have a chat, very civilised, you provide me your details, and then we'll have a discussion about why you're here, and boundaries that we would like to try and set.
So, if I didn't like somebody else's fashion sense, I could go in the police on them?
By all means, if you want to go down that line, but if you think...
Because what is wrong, I mean, what...
Well, as simple as this, okay? If I'm walking through the woods, and I come across folk like you, dressed like this, not folk like you, but people dressed like this...
See people dressed
could,
like this,
I'm just going to say, not walking down with like this...
Wouldn't be walking down the street with these on my face?
You're not, but you're in here, and there is, whether you like it or not, a legal event going on. He's obviously saying it's illegal, and that's fine, we'll look into that, that's not a problem. But, a beautiful morning like this, people out, running around their horses, doing whatever, and they come across three individuals like this. Bearing in mind, it is now, the current climate, is a heightened level of terrorism threat. Be it domestic or international. I'm telling you what we, the police, get as information. We, in our stations, have it, terrorism level, as intense or what, not
severe.
Intense.
Severe. They know what we're doing. Okay. You're here to monitor a hunt. They do not think we're terrorists.
You're
yeah,
not
everybody
allowed
knows.
To stand in the middle of the countryside and record people.
We're not allowed to roam.
So yeah, you're right to roam, but the right
to
phone beer or anything that's running about. Yes, we can.
Listen, you're following the hunt. Listen, don't think I can't.
But I thought we're terrorists.
Sorry?
A way to set a bomb or something.
I don't even joke around with that.
I mean, but make up your mind. One minute we're meant to be terrorists.
I'm saying you, because ultimately, last season, we got complaints from people had nothing to do with the hunt. Oh, there's a car with four people parked outside my house in this attire. What's going on? Is my house about to get broken into? Okay? There's other people who do utilise the right road, walking dogs, etc.
The usual
coming
one
across these guys.
Terrifying a little old lady. I don't think we're going to find a little old lady in here.
Well, believe it or not, you terrified quite a few little old ladies last year, and we'll let that slide, to be perfectly honest.
So if...
All we're saying, I have no problem with these guys protesting.
We're not protesting, though. We're monitoring the hunt because, we've seen...
Not allowed to come into the middle of the countryside and record people.
We're monitoring the hunt and we're filming the hunt.
You're not allowed.
For educational purposes.
It's very good, good one. You're not allowed to record people in the middle of the countryside.
It's a public place. You're allowed to be here. We're not breaking the law.
You're
not interfering. Because if they're breaking,
if you're interfering, we were standing over there. We heard you all hollering, shouting, snapping, and whatnot. Now that we know. So tricks of your trade.
We've not seen any
tricks of your trade. I'm just telling you what I've heard myself since I've been here.
How do you
what
know who
footage?
Was shouting and we weren't shouting?
I've came into the direction that it came from, and lo and behold, the first three people I've seen are you guys. So my suspicion is, you guys have been involved in this.
It's funny how we're getting interviewed, maybe for the hunt we're getting interviewed about illegal hunting.
What did I just say? You overheard me. You've got a complaint that it's some form of illegal hunt. We deal it call-by-call basis, okay? Their call came in first.
Not that I know of.
So, well, it's up, you know, there's a log of calls, and we said, there's people, known people, who belong to the Grampian Hunt Sabs and all that sort of stuff, are up where the hunt is at the minute. So, that's that. Now, we can do this a really civil way, okay? I do not want to be down the formal route. I do not want to do that, okay? Because I fully respect your issues with the hunt. You're right to protest, but you have to stay within boundaries. You don't. I've seen it with my own eyes. And, I'm sorry, just before we go, they've overstepped the mark on a couple of occasions last year. Kevin Newell made the complaints. I dealt with two of them in particular. There wasn't enough evidence to proceed with one of them, and charges were brought against somebody else. So it's not like we're picking on these guys. These guys made legitimate complaints last year as well, which were dealt with. None of these guys got arrested last year down here. But a member of the hunt did. So I'm not going to debate the whole issue of fox hunting, okay? That's not what we're here for. We're here just to deal with complaints. And the hunter made a complaint, and these guys have made a complaint, okay? And he's overheard me saying, listen, I'll happily speak to you. Chooses to be particularly evasive. Okay? We've made strides to contact for this. Okay? and nothing's happened. He's refused to engage with us. That's his choice. We don't want that.
Yeah.
If you run around the countryside dressed like that, it can be perceived as creating an environment of fear.
That's not our intention.
It's not and what your intention is. I'm just saying to you, if somebody...
I see people running about the countryside in camo all the time.
With beanies on to here and snoods up to here?
Yeah, often, yeah.
Well, that's very good. Phone the police if you're worried about it.
Yeah, not worried.
That's fine. Other people are.
And often these people have got loaded guns as well, which...
Phone the police. Mm-hmm. That's what we're here for. Phone the police. That's what we're here for. If you want to make a complaint, you phone the police. That's what we're here for. So, I would much... I know who you are, sir. I'm not sure who you two are. So that's what I'm asking you. Just don't want to go down the civil route, because we, as police officers, can also perceive it to be an environment of fear and alarm. You know? And I could quite legitimately detain the three of you. Because when we saw you, you were like this.
You can't see you've been standing there keeping beasties up here.
Well, you say that there's a fiscal or a sheriff if I went that far.
See,
I have no wish to do that. I have no wish to waste my time.
Snoods and everything.
Yeah. When it's like -2 and snowing, not when it's a beautiful sunny morning.
I saw one like 2 weeks ago.
Yeah,
so.
Anyway,
which
are you going to?
And how are you so sure you know who I am?
I am. Was I spoke with you last year?
Not to me, you didn't.
Yep. And you were spoken to on Saturday. I was emailed about it. And photographs were sent to me. You not spoken to and said you be very careful about how you're dressed and your attire?
Yes, I'm never wear them anything. But I'm in your car.
Hey, if you want to go down the formal route, it's not a problem, okay? We can detain you, take you away. Maybe you were spoken to last week by officers about your attire and being wary about perceptions and how it could be perceived and how it may be create an element of fear and alarm, an environment of fear, etc., which there is a crime to it. It's a very, very open crime and can be interpreted in many different ways. Now, if you've been standing here like this, not shouting and bawling and snapping these whips
shouting.
And whatnot,
I wasn't snapping.
I didn't say you.
I said,
I've overheard people.
You've overheard people.
I've overheard people. From this direction,
and
I've walked within a minute, I have found people, these guys, okay? Now, that's a separate crime. We've got legislation up to our eyeballs. We can get round pretty well anything to find the right little piece of legislation. As I've said, I do not want to go down that line, okay? So, just to confirm your details, please, sir. Thank you. Date of birth, please. Address, please.
You already have it.
Can you just confirm it for me, please? Do you have a contact telephone number?
No.
Where were you born, sir? Are you working at the moment, sir?
Do I need to get that by law?
Nope.
So, no comment.
No, fine. No problem. Can I just have a look at your snood, please? It's skulls. What's it saying you've been here, sir? 6'1"? 6'2"? 6 feet?
3'2", please.
Has anybody been contacted by a constable called Ian White?
Maybe.
If you have, could I suggest, please, contact him. Just listen to what he has to say. That's all I'm going to say. I've been asked to encourage any time I speak to anybody. Just encourage that. Sorry, what's your name? I'm just going to give you the heads up. If we suspect that you've been involved in a crime, and that's not just you, but in general policing terms, if we come across people we suspect they've been involved in the crime, we can seize pretty well anything we think that's linked to the crime, such as phones, recording equipment, whistles, horns, radios. Okay.
Could I just point out, and I don't know if you want to write it down, that sure. We're just here because we believe that there's an illegal hunt to the
yeah.
police. That's
I appreciate that.
Good job, Dan.
Thank you. I appreciate that. Can I ask you, why do you believe it's an illegal hunt?
Well, we've seen them encouraging the hounds in these woodland, and we never saw any guns in place in
to
the
begin
woodland.
With, yeah.
yeah, to begin with.
For quite some time, we were watching them before they even knew we were about, and they were encouraging hounds to hunt and things on the other side of the woodland. There was no guns whatsoever in place.
Well, as I said, you know, I will make an arrangement after today, because we're dealing with this right now. If you give me a contact detail, or you give me somebody who I can speak to, obviously, Mr. planning to give me his contact number, it's perfectly fine.
I can't remember
fine.
Our phone numbers. You've already got our phone number anyway.
I am more than happy to come meet you, sit down, get a statement from you, and say, and go to the hunt, and say, this is the allegation. But you need to provide evidence.
Yeah.
Mm. You know?
And that's why, well, yeah, that's why we're filmed, so it
I appreciate that, but there's a fine balance between recording people in the middle of the countryside. You've got to be wary of right to privacy, breaching human rights, all this sort of stuff.
And they do film us as well.
Yeah, they film us, and we're only interested in filming them when they're on a hunt.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's our interest.
And have you got an issue with that?
Nope.
No. Well, as I say, if you do, you let me know. They've got an issue about being recorded and what they perceive. I'm not perceived, and
so
what they believe they're acting perfectly legally.
They don't want us to catch them breaking the law, obviously. And if they're acting within the law, what have they got to hide?
Well, you were here last year. Did you find them breaking the law last year?
Yes, we did. Yeah,
there was an occasion when someone actually pointed a loaded gun
yes,
at someone
and,
as well.
And that individual has been arrested and charged for that.
You're quite right.
Yeah, so, but in terms of
and they were trying to dig a badger set at the time.
Which
but yeah,
wasn't
on
active.
The,
I went out with the Scottish National Heritage, and that set was deemed not active, just as there was one that was a complaint that came in the very, very first week last year about an active badger set. I went out with the Scottish National Heritage, who are completely independent of us, and they deemed it not active, which doesn't break the law. So I have no problem you coming to me with complaints like that. But
there's numerous times when they've sent the hounds into wooded areas and there was absolutely no guns in place.
I don't mean this to sound disrespectful, but do you know the actual law?
Yeah, they're allowed to use guns to, hounds to flush to a gun,
yeah,
and all that.
So
if they're sending in hounds into an area and there's no guns in place, who are they flushing to?
Maybe you haven't seen the guns. I have personally
seen.
If we're at one end of the woods here today.
If we're at one end of the woods and they send the hounds
in here, it's just
here,
my turn. I wasn't sure what the position of the hounds were doing. But I know we've spoken to them, right? We've sat down and had a meeting with them this year, okay? And saying.
They're not going to sit there and say, yes, we are breaking the law, are they?
No, but
obviously.
There's a fine balance between evidence gathering and monitoring